Meteorologist Heather Waldman takes a closer look at PFAS and what scientists know.
PFAS, P-F-A-S, is the term used for poly and perfluoroalkyl substances.
And there are thousands of chemicals under that PFAS umbrella.
Two of the most well-known PFAS are PFOA and PFOS.
Both of which were used in all sorts of products starting in the 1960s.
Classic coatings of surfaces that could be used on carpets or food packaging to help protect the packaging or protect the carpets could be used in apparel.
Production of PFOA and PFOS stopped when scientists recognized possible health risks, but these forever chemicals are still around.
They've been phased out of production, yet they remain in the environment.
As are thousands of others in the PFAS category, including in waterways all over the U.S. Fish living in contaminated waters ingest the chemicals where they accumulate with time.
And so fish can be a pathway for exposure as well through bioaccumulation and biomagnification through the food chain.
Meaning other animals and us humans can accumulate these toxins too. Researchers at Duke University recently found that PFAS contamination in fish is a nationwide problem, and that more research is needed to determine a safe level of PFAS exposure.
So this study did a great job of showing us that PFAS are an issue, and it's been looked at in other water bodies throughout California, but it doesn't give us enough information to actually develop an advisory.
An advisory that would be similar to warnings about mercury consumption. To get there, toxicologists need more environmental and health data. In the meantime, water providers throughout California are tracking PFAS levels in surface and well water.
We've been testing for PFAS since about 2019. And since that time in rivers, we've had non-detect levels, so very, very low concentrations, basically to the point where our equipment can't test any lower.
But some Sacramento area ground wells had to be taken offline due to contamination and likely won't be brought back on. Scientists agree the elimination of PFOS and PFOA chemicals is a positive step.
But if we only shut down, you know, production and use of two amongst a class of thousands, we're not really looking at what's happening with all of these other related compounds.
But eliminating all of these potentially toxic forever chemicals from production is a long ways away.
I think this is a real challenge into the future for understanding how we make sure to change from kind of a whack-a-mole type approach of saying, well, here's one that's problematic. We know that.
For KCRA 3 News, I'm meteorologist Heather Waldman.
$2 billion in federal funding is meant to be allocated to California to address forever chemicals. A total of $10 billion has already been spent across the country.